morning edition from NPR News. I'm Renee Montana.
Manscaped later this month. An energy company that wants to drill near Lake National Park goes to federal court for the right to do so. Some environmental groups and Native American tribes want to stop this. Montana Public Radio's Corin Cates Carney reports.
A few miles outside Glacier National Park in northwest Montana, Blackfeet tribal historian John Murray walks through tall grass on the ancestral home of his people, another known as the Badger to Medicine.
I wish I could get a form where even lightweight was actually light.
Development leases, but Murray doesn't want drilling to begin.
For being your own person all these years,
I appreciate knowing that it means a lot to me.
Well, you deserve all that and more. I've known you a long time, and you just constantly amaze me.
Thank you.
Taylor and Dick Titus in Eureka Ridge, Arkansas. They married 2 years ago. Their conversation will be archived at the Library of Congress. Get the podcast on iTunes and NPR.org. Major support for StoryCorps comes from Subaru, automotive partner of the National Park Service Centennial. Subaru encourages people to explore America's trails and discover a national park adventure at findyourpark.com. Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru. I'm from Cancer Treatment Centers of America. I'm a Subaru story from the power of listening. Committed to treating every cancer patient as unique. And believing that every patient's story occurs.
How do you make this pronunciation?
Well, that's part of it. And I think that if he's going to say that he's a danger to the country, and you've seen this unified message from Subaru super PAC spending $16 million against Donald Trump. You've seen other campaigns now. People who were working for other campaigns now putting out opposition research against Donald Trump when it comes to Trump University, his failed plans, anything like that. But last night in the debate, that undercut that whole message. If he's so dangerous for the country, how could all four people on that stage say that Donald Trump would be fine in a general election to support him, even if there was some hesitancy there? If he's that dangerous, it undercuts their argument.
Not only that, even Romney did not seem to think that he had come in time to behind another nominee. He talked of the other candidates, such as Rubio and Cruz, splitting up the race. There might be a deadlocked convention. That's a pretty desperate scenario.
It was pretty amazing to listen to him strategically tell people, vote for Marco Rubio in Florida, vote for John Kasich, and anybody else who would beat Donald Trump in any other state. You know, there are really three scenarios.
So, getting even narrower, and that's helping me get lower on the back.
In their view, they think that they
but as I get tired, it's still. So that is, I really have to get narrower and lower,
and then they'd have to try
and then it's less back work.